Mousehole, West Cornwall, has a proud legacy of fishing and was once the predominant village in Mounts Bay. The village was touched by tragedy in 1981, unwelcomingly thrust into the media following the loss of 8 of its sons to the sea, the same waters that had sustained the village and allowed it to prosper for centuries. Fishing is a way of life. Most come into it as their fathers fished before them. It remains a particularly male-dominated environment. Sons join fathers as deckhands. They progress and become skippers. Once, this was on family-owned boats, but the sense of patriarchy persists even on today's company boats. I knew my great-grandfather, David Sleeman. A quiet man, always smartly turned out and considered in what he said. His father fished. His uncle fished. He went to sea with him aged 14. At 19, he won the RNLI Bronze Medal for saving lives at sea.
It was a fine day. The night before, it was very bad. We didn't work. We were working long lines then, 20, 30 miles off. And when we got up around the cattle, seen this wreck in there, and Andrew said, slow the boat down, there were a few out there, and wherever you mentioned, we went and picked them off.
Whereabouts on the ship were the men?
In the rigging.
These were proud men. Tough men. Quiet men. Chasing the fish, Grandad owned his own boat and fished all around Ireland and the British Isles. Adapting to catch what was available, with no radios and no satellite navigation. Fishing in Ireland and Scotland, they found their harbours by dead reckoning. My other great-grandfather, Orlando, was in the Navy, later a shipwright. His son Frank followed him, and my Uncle Keith followed them all, going to sea. But fishing was in decline in Mousehole. Pilchard stocks, the mainstay of local fishing, moved away. Deeper and non-tidal, Newlyn took over being able to cope with the new, bigger trawlers that were emerging. Then, in 1973, the UK joined the EEC and fishing rights were given away.
Yeah, I was born in 2 St James's Place, which is your granny's house.
Yes.
Lived there until, unfortunately, 1980, 81, 82, when my dad was lost on the local, on the Penny Lifeboat disaster. He was lost on that. You know, my son was born in Mousehole, which I'm very proud of. My dad was born in Mousehole, which I'm very proud of. My grand, so I can trace our history about generations in Mousehole. I remember a Mousehole man, true Mousehole man, once said to me, "Be fiercely proud of your Cornishman," which I am, but I'm more fiercely proud that I'm a Mousehole man. Because I think being a Mousehole man is something very special. You look at the history of seagoing in England, and Mousehole is at the centre of all that.
What do you think has killed off the ability to fish for Mousehole?
I think it was demise of the pilchard fishery, because Mousehole was built on pilchards. I also believe that the fishing industry in all of the UK originated from Mousehole. I think they were the first ones that started fishing many, many generations ago. And the pilchard shoals disappeared, and basically they had to adapt. I mean, yeah. It was always the pilchard driving, maybe in the summer or autumn, and then it was long line in and stuff like that, but it all changed. And the vessels changed. Newlyn developed, because Mousehole obviously is tidal, where Newlyn isn't, so the boats got bigger, and they had to diversify what they was doing. So they started trawling, and which the boats changed the way they was designed, the way they was built. And Newlyn being non-tidal, you can get Newlyn any time, it was just the opposite thing to do. Because when I grew up here, I mean, there wasn't that. There was few boats who worked in the old-timers, but most of the fishermen in Mousehole worked for Newlyn. You know, I did when I left school, I went and worked for Newlyn. What I didn't like, and this is the deterioration of Mousehole itself. The locals moved away, and what I get all the time, I get people saying, well, the locals were greedy. No, the locals weren't greedy. They said that it couldn't be further from the truth, because there's a lot of locals who would love to live back in Mousehole again, local people. But I think what happened, it was the employment things, and predominantly Mousehole years ago, everyone went fishing. My year at school, I'm in the early 60s. I went to Aymore School. I left school at 15, and I think I was the last year of that year in school where 70% of the boys I went to school with all went fishing, and that was probably the last of it. But then what happened is the local people who wanted to buy the houses, it was outbid and they couldn't afford to. It was boats all the way, and you know, I started playing. We had a little, we call a punt, a little sculling boat, and we all used to go sculling, and there's wads of kids in the harbour all the time, summertime. Wintertime maybe not so much because obviously the harbour was shut, but yeah, it was just, I had a fantastic childhood. We all did, just, it was just boats all the way. It was like, I say to people then, it was like swallows and Amazons were salt water. That's what it was. It was just boats. Everything was boat orientated. But in those days too, I mean, I remember when I was a kid, I mean, I'm talking about really young, 8, 9 year old, jumping aboard with Butts and people like that and Jack Worth and going to sea with them and just learning your trade, really learning. You know, it's all fantastic. When my ancestors, your ancestors were fishing here, it was a way of life. That's what they did. They were fishermen. So you had your granddad and all the family on a family boat, because it was the way they made the money. Now, fishing, the problem with fishing is we got good at it. And the bigger boats and big companies got involved with the fishing, so it's no longer a way of life. It's a big multi-million pound business. And yeah, they've got to make it pay, and that's what after the demise of the fishing industry was.
How do you think the second homes and holiday homes industry has affected the village? Do you think it's a positive thing or a negative, or a bit of balance?
It's a negative thing, I think, personally, that, but I was born and raised here, so I've got the outlook from all walks, if you like. But the old Aylett thing, not a bad thing, because if people want to live in the village, locals, they still can, and they get employed by tourism, by cleaning the cottages and stuff like that. So it is interesting, but I do think there's too many of them. The second home thing, and that's what will kill this village. Because if you've got the money to buy a second home, and you're talking about buying houses in Mousehole, 3-bedroom house for like £1 million, where no way any local can compete with that. No. It's bringing nothing into this village, nothing
no.
at all.
No.
The holiday nets, at least you've got people using, the local restaurants,
yeah,
the pubs.
yeah, it's just a nice growing up here, you know, at the boys' brigade, and everybody knew everybody, and nobody had a lot of money, but you know, we just lived all right, I think, and did the best we could, you know. Your granny had always looked after my granny. Had a fish and chip shop just around the corner down by the pub there, and like ordinary children. We played down the harbour, because we had no football field in their days, so our football field was out the bank.
When do you think fishing started dying off in the village?
Oh, well, I suppose when the older people, you know, passed on and the boats got sold. That's a thing, you know, I can remember perhaps 6 or 8 biggish boats in Mousehole when,
yeah,
I was young, but they just depleted over the years, and then moved to Newlyn as well, you know.
Yeah.
Fishing out of Newlyn.
They were self-sufficient.
Yeah.
Mousehole people, they caught fish. They brought the fish to Mousehole, it was processed in Mousehole and exported from Mousehole. There was no outside influence. The only thing they couldn't do in Mousehole is produce salt. So
yes,
they had to bring salt in, and what would happen, the main trade of for hundreds of years was the Italian market and the Spanish market.
I'd like to take you back to Mousehole back in the 1950s. Mousehole was much quieter than it is today. And my grandparents lived here, and I came in the summer holidays and kind of hung out with my cousin, and we swam, and we had a small punt, and we sculled across the harbour and out to the island, Mousehole Island, St Clement's Isle.
And also see how Mousehole has changed. When I was growing up in Mousehole, there were 3 grocery shops, 2 butchers, there was even a haberdashery. You could buy all sorts, you could buy shoes, everything. You never had to go out of Mousehole. And now there's nothing.
Yeah.
There's not even a paper shop here anymore.
No.
Post office, nothing.
No.
And that is reflection on, there's no one here. Winter time, Mousehole's dead.
You were a youngster, there was still a lot of shops here, and I can certainly remember as a child being sent out by my grandmother in the morning to go around and fetch all her groceries. So you were saying 3 greengrocers. Was there one? What, there was more than one butcher here at one time, wasn't there?
Two butchers. I remember, yeah. One up Regent Terrace, and there was the Bone, which was down the bottom of Brook Street.
Yeah.
People in their 80s, where do they get their shopping from? You can't even get, you can't get a pint of milk here. There is a couple of shops you can still get milk, the basic stuff, bread and milk, but nothing else.
But that's from delicatessens, isn't it?
Delicatessens.
What's happened to all those shops now? What have they become, sort of, in the modern tourist industry, if you like?
Tap shops selling crap, or selling rubbish, selling what people want to buy.
Yeah.
And it's no good in the village. I don't agree with it, but there's nothing I can do with it.
No.
And, people go make a living, and we've got people who come here to live who bought shops, and they're here to, I got Mousehole and all that. People do come here still to live here, and they come here and they love it as much as I do, which I love. But the community is nothing like it was when I was growing up.
It's gone downhill, Paul. All holiday lets. There's a holiday let in the back here, and it's nearly all. I don't suppose it's what you're racking up. Three, four local people in the street now.
As you walk through the narrow scenic streets, many front doors are sporting familiar little metal boxes opened by combination locks, key safes, a pretty good indicator that these properties are short-term holiday lets.
Obviously quite a lot of the second homes have people who come in to stay and might take a tour with me, but it does affect me personally in the sense that I can't afford to buy here and our rental market is very poor.
And we were shocked at how empty it was. So many houses in darkness with no sign of Christmas decorations in them. I then realised just how damaging second homes and holiday lets can be.
Because you've got nowhere now, hardly anywhere left. I mean, when I was a boy, you had 2 summer schools, St Clement's Hall, Salvation Army Hall, and the meeting house in your 5 or 6 places that you had meetings. Both summer schools are gone. There will be houses, one is a house now, and the other one will be flats. It's probably sell for $1 million.
Yeah.
It's only the Pezzics further up the road and us here,
who are
local.
Yeah.
But this is just a holiday village now, really.